Alright, hanging out today at Rockaway Beach with the family. Family, say hi. My Jackie. Wait. Kai and Kalea. Kalea, say hi to everybody.
Hi.
Hi. What are we going to do today? What are we going to catch?
Crabs.
Crabs. Big ones or small ones?
Big ones and small ones.
Big ones and small ones. So, Nick is actually out there right now. You can see him on the kayak. The little dot right there. So, surf is pretty decent today. Actually, it was supposed to be small, but it looks kind of big. So we're gonna see if we can toss some snares, and I'll show you guys how to set the snares up, bait the snares, and weigh the snares, and let's see if we can catch some Dungeness crab. And if we do catch some, we have a really good dip that we're gonna make out of it. So stay tuned and be prepared for some Dungeness crab dip. Got this beautiful Spartan surf rod that I got from Ray Fishing right here, and it's a perfect 13 foot casting rod that we're gonna use for some crab. So for real, you're casting too hard, that's why.
Yeah, I don't know, it's just probably 9 years old.
It was time. And so one of our neighbors mentioned that he caught in about an hour and a half about 7 good sized keeper crabs. So, but that was during high tide, so we'll see what we can get. Pen, okay, so I'll cast over there. Sounds good. So current's pulling south, so we'll cast a little bit north, and we'll add weight if we need to. Okay, in California you need a 6-loop snare, so I actually bought one. A lot of people make their own. So this is it in a package. We'll show you how to bait it up and throw it in there. What I have for bait today is some smelt and some salmon, some super old salmon, so we'll see. So here's the snares. Let me get the weight for this thing. So I'm gonna open this up and tie in like a flat weight for it right on the door. That way you can just put it in here, throw on your bait, close this up, and close the door. So we'll tie it to our line right here. Okay, we'll tie it on. Some anchovies. Anchovies right here. Some salmon. Stuffed anchovies in here. Oh, even some smelt in here as well. Oh yeah, smash it all in here. Ooh, this is a nice fat smelt. Get that smelt in here. Stuff it. All right, let's see if we can catch some crab. Wearing the wrong shoes today. Oh damn. Not far enough. All right. Cast it again. We'll let it just hang out for a little bit. Let that thing settle. Yeah, this one feels heavy. Maybe it's more seaweed. I think it's seaweed. We'll see. I hope it's not seaweed. This thing was rolling around the weeds. Please be a big one. Please don't be seaweed. Oh yes. Oh, it might be a keeper. I think it's small. So, this crab snare, I don't know, I think it's small. We can see it, yeah, it's small, it's a short. But we can see that this crab snare isn't that great at all. It's a short one. I don't have to measure this one. I can already tell. So I'm gonna put this thing down and see if we can catch another one. But at least we're hooking them with the snare, so it's fun. Okay, Nick's on his way in. Whoa, Nick, you are awesome.
Three of my pots got flipped over by the seal too.
Oh, really?
Dang.
How many hoop nets you got in there right now?
Six.
Holy crap.
One was empty, these are just two pots.
That's nice. Nice, flipping them all around, huh?
Well, nice one. It's turning on right now.
Yeah, because the tide's turning. Look at that, beautiful crab. Ooh, that's a nice one.
Five.
Bigger now here, huh?
Yep.
Yeah, just...
It's right there, right?
Yeah, I just need more. Five.
That one? Feels like it. Yeah.
I hope it's not seaweed.
I don't know, we'll see.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Oh! Snare, grab it!
Oh, keeper! 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 Keeper!
Come on, dude. Oh. Did you do that on purpose?
yeah. I did it for the drama.
That's a nice size one.
That's
too.
A keeper! Oh man, I'm so happy right now. Thank you. Thank you for the pointers, Nick. It's
no.
Because of Nick, everybody. I got this nice crab.
I'm the one
right
that
here.
Said it's not gonna work.
Yeah. Oh man. Oh man. So the salmon for bait and the anchovy for bait actually worked out pretty good. So Yeah, I can eat. I'm gonna measure it, but this is definitely a keeper for sure. So I'll go measure it right now. The measurement for the Dungeness crab. Right here to right here. Yeah. That's how you measure these things. Inside to inside. Not tip to tip. So keep that in mind. 6.5, so. Thank you, Nick, for telling me that I wasn't gonna catch any crabs. Right here is proof.
Yeah, rub it in my face a little more.
Look at that. Man, crabs. All right, so we got the water boiling here. And we got the kids and the family in the background. So we're gonna boil this thing up and we're gonna make a crab dip. So we're gonna do an Old Bay seasoning crab dip. We're gonna boil the crab, separate everything, and just mix it all up with some cream cheese, chives, or cream cheese and cilantro. Mix it all up and see what we can make here. So once the water starts boiling, we'll go ahead and make all this stuff right here and then just enjoy that crab dip. So stay tuned, we're gonna do it. It was an amazing day. I mean, I got to catch the crab on the snare. Initially, Nick made my heart fall because he was like, you ain't catching anything with these, but proved them wrong once again. So as you can see, we have all these crabs. Stay tuned for the crab dip that we're about to make and let's get cooking. Okay, due to the unprecedented domoic acid levels, it's recommended that you actually remove the head from these things. So we're gonna go ahead and just remove the head. So rear the carapace, rear the, you could actually use a knife. Actually, I'll use this. I'll use a spatula to just, it's a quick way of just killing them, so. And that's it. Done, removed. Quick, simple, easy, and complete. So you wanna get rid of all these guts right here and all this, these gills. So we're gonna get rid of the guts and gills. And then, what's happening?
Where did you find us?
I found it where you were surfing at.
No.
Yeah, just go underwater and just go grab some.
You have everything to go underwater?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
But I actually caught it from my fishing pole.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pretty cool. Right?
But I do dive for them, so.
Okay, have a bon appetit.
Hey, have a good one. Yeah. So, we'll clean this up. We'll get all the guts out of it. Make it nice and clean. Separate the gills. Best way to do them, in half. So right here, you just hold them as like so. Done, easy, clean. Remove, once you remove some of these gills and the excess, simple. And it's set. Here as well, the gills set. See that? Done. Remove the rear fin. Done. I told you, man. That's when you doubt.
On film?
When you doubt me, that's what happens.
You caught it on the crab snare? Oh my god.
When you doubt me, this is what happens.
Oh my gosh. These things are huge.
You saw me bring up the big ones. When you doubt me, that's what happens.
Wow.
You should never doubt me anywhere.
That's pretty crazy, Jay.
Hey, you know. Wow. Look at this. So we got some of the uni from a couple of our buddies who actually went underwater to go get them. And Nick's going to give these to Grandpa. So amazing. With amazing catch with the amazing,
we ain't got no marbles,
Pelican 30 cooler. Oh man, I see a limit of crabs in here. Oh man, that's beautiful. Jeez, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh my gosh. If anybody's looking for a great all-around cooler for Northern California to store rockfish, crabs, uni, cabazon, whatever you need.
Not softball size uni though.
Oh man, yeah, we don't want to smash
those.
You're gonna need the cooler that I got. But this is a 30, it's perfect. And hold drinks and all that, and have a ton of ice. Beautiful cooler. Check it out. Check them out at pelican.com. All right. Started throwing these crabs in here. Getting kind of windy, so I can't do it up there no more. They're nice and clean. Let's get them all in there in this hot water. Cover it up. Oh yeah. Block the wind. I'm gonna throw the cream cheese in here. Sunnyside Farms, 8 ounces of cream cheese. While this, this is still, the crab's still boiling. So, nice and soft. Prep everything beforehand. Go. This thing fell in the sand, but I needed a cup of it, so hopefully I can get a cup of this. It's about a cup right there. We'll call that good. See that? Old Bay seasoning. Oh yeah, Old Bay seasoning. This is winter right here. I use this for a lot of stuff when it comes to crab. This is some good. Kalea, you want some?
Sweet.
You want some crab? Fresh crab? He don't want any. He don't want any. Try. Is it good? Yeah. Let it cool down, I'll start separating this. And then once I add the crab, it should start melting down. Start tossing the crab meat in here. This is the hard part.
Gotta be a good thing. These things are meaty.
So here's the product. Both crabs, deshelled. Mixing it up. So. Okay. Cut this cilantro up right here. Can't forget the cheese. Give it a shot right here. I'm excited. Give it a. Oh man, with the cheese and the crab, the flavor of the crab and the Old Bay seasoning. Oh man. The Old Bay gives it a nice, like, salty flavor to it with all the herbs in there and the little spice. It's really good. Oh man, I can eat this all day. Oh my god, cilantro. Feel a nice kick too. But that's really good. I learned a lot today for snaring from my neighbor, who was actually showing me how to do it. And I hope you all had a good time watching this film, showing how to crab snare, making this crab dip. Amazing, give it a shot. A plus right here for the recipe, for the crab recipe. If you're trying to figure out what you're trying to do next, breadsticks and crab dip for your next party, check it out. So please give it a thumbs up, like, subscribe if you like what you see here, and I'll see you next time for another episode of Fish Dive Cook. Peace. Ready?
Daddy.
Okay.
That looks good.
Yeah.
I want with the cheese.
Okay, I'll give you with the cheese.
With the cheese.
You only want cheese?
It has cheese for it.
Cheese right there. It's like a baby ice cream. One more. Ooh. I ate it all up.